Cape Town Marathon. And for us at KFM 94.5, we are proud media partners to the marathon, and we are so honored to be here. I know my colleague Greenan Esther is also in the room. He's also here representing for our CEO, Trish Taylor, who is sick at the moment, and she would have loved to be here, but she does send her regards. So another special welcome to Mariska Oosthuizen, who is the head of brand from Sanlam. Yes, boss lady. Alderman J.P. Smith, City of Cape Town's Mayoral Committee member for safety and security. And we will be talking very serious things with you in a few minutes. And we also have Lisa Ellis, Senior Manager, Brand Comms Sport for Adidas South Africa. A brand I live and love. Of course, Trish Taylor, our CEO, couldn't be here. Patrick Hardy, Head of Strategic Partnership and Sponsorship at Virgin Active. Welcome to you. René Haldenes, Events and Sponsorship Manager at Woolworths. Clark Gardner, Group CEO of Faces, whose face you'll see shortly. Ilana Meyer, Sanlam Cape Town Marathon Ambassador and Elite Athlete. Renee Jordan, Sanlam Cape Town Marathon Race Director. We also have Barry Van Burg, the General Manager of the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon, who has lost a few hairs since the last time I saw him, but still in good spirits. Ernest Van Dyke, Sanlam Cape Town Marathon Elite Wheelchair Race Ambassador. Lionel Claassen, Chairman of Sanlam Cape Town Marathon. And Farouk Meyer, the President of Western Province Athletics. And all of you who are equally esteemed and important. So welcome. And we have officially reached the 80-day countdown of the 2022 Sanlam Cape Town Marathon. For all of you running the race, I hope the preparation is going well and you are excited about hitting the road in October. And under the steady guidance of the event's passionate team, who I've had the pleasure of working with over the last couple of months, seeing the hard work going on behind the scenes to make this the exceptional race that it is. I know there's excitement behind the scenes there. I mean, this race harnesses the latest trends. It is a gem on the African running calendar, and something Cape Town and the Western Cape should be extremely proud of. And in addition to being Africa's only World Athletics Gold Label Marathon, 2022 also marks the first of three evaluation processes as an Abbott World Marathon Majors candidate. We want to join the likes of New York, we want to join Boston, Berlin, London, Tokyo, and Chicago as, you know, one of the top races in the world. And so it is very exciting going for that goal in 2025. Mark your calendars, people. It is happening. And as part of this candidacy period, the event must meet a lot of stringent requirements in order for us to achieve this important goal. And there are some very important people who will talk us through the very tough process of getting to where we need to get to. I'd like to welcome Alderman J.P. Smith to the panel, Ilana Meyer and Clark Gardner, who will tell us a little bit about what it takes to put a marathon like this together. So please, have a seat.
Thanks.
Welcome.
Nice to see you, Ilana.
You're smiling now. I want to see if you'll be smiling in a few minutes when Alderman J.P. Smith gets a hold of you. But yes, so welcome everybody. Nice to see you, Lana.
Nice.
Thank you for being you and for doing this thing, by the way. I just wanted to say what an exciting, gift you've given the city of Cape Town in being one of the founders of the Cape Town Marathon. So what a legacy, man.
Thank you.
All right, okay. So, the route, all right. There's going to be some major changes. There's going to be some challenges. I want you to take us through it. Congratulations on the route approval. That must have been some paperwork that you had to submit there. Extensive process, tough process. I see you still smiling, so it didn't finish you. Can you talk us through some of the challenges that brought you to this point of approval?
Yeah, thanks. So I'm gonna hold the airtime just for a few minutes now. Because you give me the opportunity to do it.
Yes.
But many of you here may well know the passion and commitment we have for a cause, to take you back a step, a cause that we think is extremely significant for our continent in that more than 80% of the world's top-ranked marathon runners are from Africa. We are home to the runners that currently hold the world records for marathon running. This is home to the Olympic champions, both male and female, to the World Athletics World Champion Marathon Runners, both male and female, and home to all the current six title holders of the Abbott World Marathon Majors. It's all from Africa. Yet, these remarkable athletes don't get an opportunity to ever run on home turf, you know, on a world stage. You know, someone like Eliud Kipchoge, born in Kenya, trains in Kenya, lives in Kenya, has never ever had the privilege of listening to his neighbors, his fans, his people cheer him on in a marathon. He's never raced on African home soil. And you know, we get to change that. We've got the opportunity to deliver Africa's first major. We take that responsibility extremely seriously. Part of that is the route. City and ourselves designed a route that had the mantra of maximizing experience, minimizing inconvenience. And there's a balance between those two. And we fought for either side. So that's probably where some of the debate will happen. But that route needs to have a capacity and scale up to allow for 35,000 runners, which is the norm for a World Marathon Major or Abbott World Marathon's Major. It's got to be safe and really extremely convenient for both runners and participants, but also the city. And I think we delivered on that. So I don't know if we want to take everyone through that route, through a fly-through, before we start taking each element on its own. On Helen Suzman by the City bus station just after the Green Point Circle. That allows us to have 3-4 lanes to start on, which allows us to scale the race, prevents any of the jam, the participant jam that we experience in other races. That turns left onto Badenkracht. Previously we used to cross over Badenkracht in the morning after doing a few Ks, and that allows to maximize the traffic flow into the city in the morning, which is important. Then my highlight for the new route is that we get onto Nelson Mandela Boulevard, a road you'd never be able to run otherwise. And why I love it is on the left you've got the harbour and maximise the views of that beautiful harbour, but more importantly on the right, you get to run a few Ks staring at Table Mountain. And it's the best views of Table Mountain. Right up to Searle Street, where you drop into the oldest suburb of Cape Town in Woodstock. We carry on that and we right into Claremont, left into, I think it's called Letterstead, by the Southern Sun opposite Newlands Pools onto Claremont Boulevard, and we turn at Stonehill Bridge. The reason for that turnoff is to maximize, again, traffic in the Claremont precinct. It improves that situation on that side. Then Pymara Campground to enjoy the friendly southern suburbs around Rondebosch Common, home to the extremely endangered Cape Flats sand fynbos. Leersburg River, back into Salt River, Woodstock. And then importantly, we've introduced the cultural and historically importance of District 6, where 60,000 of our people were forcibly removed in the 70s. And we're liaising with that community of how to activate and make that as of strategic importance on this route. Again, we now pass the Cape Town City Hall, where Nelson Mandela made his first appearance in 1990 after being released from prison. Up St. John's, Orange River, down Long Street, and then the big fight left into Redwick Street, straight over Badenkrug, No Bridge. I think that's an important criteria for us in order to qualify as the Avid World Marathon Majors. And it was hard, and the city has come to trust us. So we thank them for that support and their efforts and insight into that. And that will be of inconvenience. There's no doubt that's going to inconvenience our city and residents and small businesses during that time. So that sacrifice is hopefully worth it, and it's a big sacrifice. We then in Somerset Road, we go under the elevated circle to again allow the traffic to work through those areas. Back onto Somerset Road, right into Glen Gareth, and then onto Beach Road, which will make it all worthwhile. Quite controversial that we're taking our participants and testing their mental strength by going past the finish with still 7Ks to go. So that will definitely be raised, that will definitely be an issue, but it certainly was the balance and trade-off, and we thought we'd test people to look at their garments and know that there's still 7Ks to go after passing the finish. We turn at Queen's Circle, and then we've got the best finish in any major marathon along Beach Road, back into Helen Suzman, and conveniently finishing 100 or 200 metres after the Virgin Active. So that's the route, and those are the major changes.
Yeah, thank you so much for that. Lots of beauty, lots of history, lots of challenges. But let's talk quickly about the Elite Wheelchair Race, which is an exciting addition to the marathon. And anyone who's followed wheelchair races at some of the other majors will know that it does add an exciting element to the race, and obviously an exciting element to the Cape Town race. But it does go quicker. So how then do you balance having the wheelchair race as part of the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon?
So firstly, if you want to be the world's leading marathon, you need to introduce and cater for an elite wheelchair race. We had Avid World Marathon Majors here to assist us in understanding the route and the convenience required for a wheelchair race. We would never have got them over the line without our ambassador, Aaron van Dijk, and a legend in the wheelchair racing, because he actually gave them comfort.
Yeah.
So thank you. Especially there by the Rondebosch Common. I know if it wasn't for you, we would not be going there. So we appreciate that. You know, that's part of being the world's best marathon, is that you've got to cater for that, and it leaves early, leaves before the elite men. They are super fast. But they finish in an hour and a half if Owens takes place, maybe even quicker. So you'll be super proud to be able to be the first marathon in this country catering for legends that we do have, such as Owens, to race the wheelchair.
Making it a more inclusive race, which is very important. 80 days, 80, less than 3 months. 80 days. There's no messing around now. It's crunch time. And I'm sure those kind of last couple of months stresses and headaches cropping up now. How has the planning been, and what's left for there to do?
So I get the easy job. I just get to talk about and brag about the great work that the team has done.
Yes.
So we've got a fantastic team with Barry, Renee, Cara, and everyone involved in this route. The city, who gave us incredible insights and their experience, really assisted. And now we've got the support of having, you know, the best partners in the game. We have not only Sanlam, African chapter, 12 months, Adidas, Prime Media, Virgin Active. And today we also welcome another vehicle sponsor, another world champion in Mercedes-Benz coming along as a sponsor. So it's a team effort, and our team is delivering. You can see we're attracting really aspirational brands, and we're all working together to execute on this event. So it's a team effort, and I'm not too worried, I'm not too concerned. It's not my hard work, it's theirs.
Okay, let's go to the city now. Let's go to the office and see what it takes to make something like this happen. JP Smith, I want to talk a little bit about what it takes to get an approval of this nature. I mean, I know it's not these aren't easy conversations. I know there's a lot of pushback sometimes. How did the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon get the approval necessary?
So this is not their first marathon. They've done this a few times. And as a consequence, much of the planning is in place. These are events organizers we trust, and we know they will do a competent performance. It's not somebody's work we have to scrutinize too diligently. We have a very diligent events office. We'll make sure that we run events properly. The worst thing you can have is for a major event to go badly. We have twice out of the last three awards won the city's Festival and Events International Destination. And that Festival and Events Award comes from hosting major events without incident, competently, efficiently, and getting all the logistics right. So that's something that the events office asserts themselves on. Make sure that we demand that from events organizers. We have had events in the last year coming out of COVID who have struggled to get back on their feet, so we do pay attention. And this particular event is presenting us with a unique challenge. It is already a great event. The top eight events in this city bring in 3 billion rand to our economy. And this is one of our signature events. It carries our name. We're proud of it. We're proud to be associated with it this year and in the past and in the future years, and they can count on our support and they know that. But in order for the event to grow and to reach those kind of participant numbers they're talking about, you have to work on the route. The route has to become more demanding and has to carry more impact. So we have worked very hard with them, and it's been a long journey to get to the point, and I'm surprised their friendships have survived, to get to the point where a new route can be presented today, and where we have the best possible impact for the runners, the best possible experience. We showcase the best the city has to offer, and we have the least possible impact on the traffic flow and congestion. But it won't be no impact. The truth is that as we scale up the event, as with every major event like this around the world, we are a candidate city for the Abbott World Marathon Major. This is a candidate event, and over the next few years, the numbers are going to stack up, and so it will become increasingly more challenging to make this work with least impact, and that means working very closely with the organizers. They have pulled out all the stops to make it possible to do this. I must commend them. But so to have the city's events office and our traffic department and the transport department to try and keep that impact at a minimum. I think the one thing I can say to the residents is that if on race day there is a bit more impact than you were maybe accustomed to last year, understand that that impact is valuable. It is creating hundreds of jobs on the day, many more jobs than that during the period, about 35,000 jobs depending on the events industry. Many of those people have suffered quite a bit during COVID and the lockdown. And events like this is rejuvenating that, and in fact creating more jobs, a huge economic stimulus for our city. Over race day, you'll see many, about a third of our runners come from Gauteng, a very large contingent from outside of the city. So you'll see all these number plates from all over South Africa, and all the international runners and the elite marathoners, which we're very proud to welcome. And with them and their supporters come a lot of additional revenue, destination marketing for the tourism industry, which supports hundreds of thousands of people in the city. So the inconvenience on the day is well worth the overall benefit for the city as a whole.
Mm. I mean, as a Cape Town resident myself, who was locked in the house for many, many months during the pandemic, I am excited for any piece of outside action, a concert, marathon. You will be getting no angry tweets from me about the marathon.
In fact, you'll be answering the angry tweets.
I think you'll find a lot of Cantonians are just very happy to be outside again and running, playing, and enjoying the city. But with that, you know, being this world-class event that it is, a lot of South Africans are excited, a lot of Cantonians will be running, you know, South Africans from the rest of the country will be coming into Cape Town, international guests will be flocking into the city. Are we ready to receive all of them with open arms and ready-made, you know, a city that can handle the numbers that the race will bring?
The short answer is heck yes. We have, this is not the first event since the relaxing of the COVID regulations. I think the events department and the various service departments, traffic, law enforcement, metro police, SAPS, disaster management, the emergency medical services, all of them have come up to speed very quickly. It's been a shock again to have to do major events, but an absolute pleasure, with major rugby games and all kinds of other sporting events taking place. And we're moving out of the space of the sort of hybrid events, which the Cape Town Marathon pioneered, and into having everybody be physically present on the street. If you are not able to go where you wanted to on the day, make the trip to the sidewalk and go and wave on the runners, because it is such a special event, especially with the increased international participation. And know that every second of that footage screened on television screens internationally is bringing more tourists and more jobs and more economic development to our city in the next year and the year after that. And on that basis, the city has been very proud to host them before they had these kind of international ambitions. And certainly now as well, this is an absolute flagship event. They're organizers who know what they're doing, and a blueprint for how events should run. So the event's approval is diligently scrutinized. There's been quite a bit of to and fro between the events office. I have to look back there, because the Tsar of events sits back there, and there's been quite a lot of to and fro, and the events office doesn't hold back. If they don't think an event is capable of being pulled up properly, they won't issue an events permit, and if they say that the route can be managed, then they're confident that it can be.
And I think that's important, and thank you for giving a perspective as to around the city's role in this. But one final, very crucial question. Will you be running?
running my mouth, yes. Verbally supporting, absolutely. I think the running is a power to weight ratio, and I tilt on the wrong side of both those equations. That's why runners look like Ilana and not like me. Although I have to tip my hat to French and others who have been able to disrupt their stuff. I think we must make sure that it's a breathtaking event. You will have seen yesterday we did the 1 year to go launch for netball. Mm-hmm. The Netball World Cup, first time in 75 years on African soil. We're very proud to do that. I've been involved with that bit all the way through from the beginning. And it's really amazing to see it get to this point. Our job is to make sure that these events are spectacular. That as well as Liverpool did it, we do it better. And as for this event, that as accustomed to runners are to having good marathons elsewhere when they come to Africa, to Cape Town, these must be special. Show them how we run a marathon on an African beat and under our skies, and that's our job to do. So when you're on the day and it's working well, then you will know that we ran a different race to get there.
Nice, thank you so much. So you won't ski.
It was a very long answer for what you were looking for. I'll run it with you. But clearly for that you will need new Adidas.
More fashion there on my side.
For me it sounds like a good excuse.
Yeah, very, very good. Ilana, to you now. For you as an elite runner, obviously the launch of a route is very, very exciting. How do you feel about it from start to finish?
You know, first of all, just well done, team, you know, for getting this over the line. Because, like, over the last couple of months, I've got phone calls from coaches, you know, how does the new route look like? You know, so, you know, at last, it's going to be out there. I'm super excited. I think we've been working, you know, with creating a world-class route over the last 8-9 years. You know, so, and this really is the legacy route. So congrats to the team, you know, the city. I'm looking really forward to, you know, to receiving, you know, the international field, the elite field, to run this new legacy route. I think fantastic start, you know, on Helen Suzman, nice, broad, flat, good road surface, you know, to get out of the blocks, you know, I think smoothly. You know, so brilliant finish. I think along the route, I'm certainly going to have an opportunity for breathtaking pictures. You know, I think athletes will really put, you know, the picture up the wall, the one with Table Mountain in the background. So very, very exciting.
I want to actually ask you about that. As an elite runner, you're moving fast. Do you really have time to look at Table Mountain? Oh, there's the harbour. I've watched you on TV, and it's focused. It's we're going for the finish line. How much of the route and the views are you able to enjoy when you're there in front of the pack?
You know, so I think, you know, obviously going to talk out of the elite athlete perspective. You know, that's me many years ago. But, you know, when you're in the route, when you're in the race on the route, you know, with the objective of, you know, walking away with the top honours, you know, you certainly, you're in the race, in the moment, you know, focusing on yourself, on your competitors, you know, and the, you know, the scenicness of the route, you know, certainly enhances the experience. But then, you know, now, you know, many years later, last year, I ran the race, you know, and certainly, you know, the scenicness of the route truly enhances the experience. You know, it's going to be very special. I think, you know, just talking about the beautiful pictures. So the elite athletes will walk away with a very, very special experience.
Let's talk technical. Okay. So this is an undulating course with only two real climbs. I'm speaking your language now. strategy. How do the athletes strategize for that, you know, in terms of preparing for a flatter course as opposed to an undulating course? Will there have to be some tweaks and training?
Yeah, absolutely. I think this is very exciting. I think you get the, you know, fast, flat marathon courses like Berlin, Chicago. It truly is pancake flat. You know, like you don't gain anything more than like a chair almost. You know, so it's very straightforward. You get into the race. It's mostly, you know, even pace running, you know, determined by pace setters. But I think getting into a race, you know, where the route is different, you know, and there we will talk about, you know, it's Cape Town Marathon will be a very similar route experience to New York Marathon, Boston Marathon. You know, so the humps being thrown into the equation will be at about 27 kilometers, 32 kilometers, and certainly will determine, you know, some tactical reaction to it. I think, you know, if you look at Boston Marathon, you know, Heartbreak Hill, you know, that always determines almost the finish result of the race. So I've got no doubt that, you know, with Sanlam Cape Town Marathon, you know, two relative significant climbs in the second half of the race will certainly need special consideration from a tactical perspective. You know, the second half is definitely more difficult, you know, and, you know, special preparation. So it's not necessarily the athlete, you know, that's the fastest runner, but it's going to be, you know, stronger and athletes that can run good tactical races that will come out on top.
Should be exciting to watch.
Absolutely. And I'm sure those two, you know, bumps will get, you know, some names, probably different names from, you know, from the back enders, you know, to the elite athletes, but, you know, they will be named.
One of my favorite things about you, Lana, is how much interest you take in youth development and, you know, growing runners of the future. What do you think a race like this adds to the excitement around marathons, particularly for the young runners who are coming up?
I think it's so essential. I think, you know, like, you know, my generation, people grew up, you know, watching Comrades Marathon, and that, you know, created the vision and the dream for many people. And I think if we want to play on the international, you know, marathon field in the Olympics, world champs, you know, we certainly need an event that can inspire, that, you know, from, igniting a dream in young runners, you know, all the way through to being an elite athlete. And I think that, you know, that was part of the dream all along, is to create the event, you know, in South Africa, in Africa, that athletes will aspire to run. You know, and it's fantastic to see, you know, runners, you know, on the women's side, there's really exciting, you know, runners that's coming through. Gerda has been, you know, magnificent, not only over the ultra, but also the marathon distance. And in the next year or two, you know, you'll see athletes like Dominique Scott, Glenn Rose, you know, stepping up to the marathon. And I think that will create fantastic racing, you know, in Cape Town. You know, and then somebody like Amelikaya France, you know, he's run five marathons, three of them in Cape Town, and every single marathon he's run faster, you know, being the top marathon finisher in, you know, the World Champs recently. So, you know, so brilliant, you know, as an inspiration for young athletes.
No, it does feel like a special time. I mean, I love that you mentioned, you know, the women runners who are coming through. We see how Manana Manana has inspired so many young footballers with their win. There were records broken at the World Athletics Championships that have inspired people. So it does feel like there's something in the energy around the sport at the moment. Let me quickly go back to you, Clark, in closing. Let's talk about Race Week. What can runners, supporters, and the city look forward to come Race Week?
Race Week, it's a festival of running. Yeah, it's five events. We've got our very own legend, Ryan Sands, hosting the 46K, or I think it might even be further, a trail race. There's a 22K. They're both extremely hard, but it involves Table Mountain. It's not difficult to sell. We've got an amazing Adidas Terex team coming to run that and race that, which will up the profile, again, of the city, of our country, or putting on events in the city. And then we've got a 5 and 10K on the Saturday, which you committed to, one of them. I can't remember if it was 5 or 10.
Number 5, right.
And then we have the marathon on the Sunday, where we've dedicated that time to this event to allow for the scale.
Yes.
Importantly, we, you know, we have an expo that's not trying to just be another retail centre. There's theatre involved. Our sponsors are activating it in incredible ways. I've seen their ideas, and it's going to be special. So that's going to be a highlight. And then entertainment. So spectators will be able to enjoy the entertainment as much as the participants. Mm-hmm. We've got bands playing. We've got a stage provided by Coca-Cola and PenBev that is 12 meters by 12 meters with sound equipment that is technically above my pay grade. It really sounds special. And that's going to, so we're putting on a theater. We're putting on a festival of running that involves spectators, participants, and as much as possible, everyone involved in the city.
Very exciting. I want to take it to the floor now. If there are any questions around the route and the plans leading up to the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon from any of you, please use this opportunity now to point at any of them to ask them the tough questions. Otherwise, we can move on. No one? Okay. Thank you so much. So, thank you. I'll call on you if there's anything further. all right, now let's have a look at why the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon is one of the continent's favorite marathons. Have a look. Thank you. primary partner for the past 8 years, who believed in the potential of Africa and her people. But before I hand over to Mariska Oosthuizen, Sanlam's head of brand, please join me in welcoming a guest performer, speaker Lebohang Masango, a celebrated South African writer and poet. Let me tell you a little bit about this woman. As a Zanele Mbeki Fellow, UNICEF Volunteer Program Advocate, and PhD candidate, Lebohang is as busy as she is passionate about anthropology and writing, and she was voted the second runner-up in the 2021 Daily Maverick Person of the Year Awards in the Youth Champion category. Her writing has been celebrated with countless awards, and we are so privileged to have her here with us. And she's put together some beautiful words about this year's Sanlam Cape Town Marathon and the incredible achievements our country and continent is making on the global sporting stage.
Thank you. The Atlantic sea breeze whispers a salty greeting. The morning mist drifts before us, parting a path that reveals only a little of what the day holds. Behold, this moment you have trained tirelessly for. The Atlantic sea breeze whispers a salty greeting. The morning mist drifts before us, parting a path that reveals only a little of what the day holds. Behold, this moment you have wished and waited for, timed yourself and trained tirelessly for. Among your fellow runners, you warm up and take your place to put your best foot forward at the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon, where victory awaits. At the sound of the starting gun, bodies lunge forward as one. Your racing heart, your determined lungs, the music of the marathon has now begun. The sharp breaths and the steady beat of running feet pound a relentless rhythm into the hard concrete. Hear the wind whistle against your body as it tries to keep pace. Feel your feet and legs power through the pain. Let that ache be a reminder that there is nothing in the world that your mind can't conquer. If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. These ancient words of wisdom we remember, and you are not alone. From our homes, our TVs, our radios, our phones, we marvel at all your strength. We spectate from the sidelines as you carry our hopes across distances and lengths. And though each one runs as an individual, today isn't only about how we compete. Runners and supporters, spectators, officials, we all collaborate to achieve the Abbott World Marathon Major's dream. We run towards that goal to make Africa's future brighter with every milestone we reach. Behold, this moment we have wished and waited for, timed ourselves and trained tirelessly for. Who we are is who we have always been, a proud people who live with confidence, knowing we are worthy of this dream, worthy of winning together beneath these open skies. We race to meet our best selves at the finish line, here in Cape Town, where African champions unite. Thank you.
Wow. Running that marathon, I'll welcome, actually I will give you the stage. I mean, you've been holding this down for 8 years. You don't need me here with you, Mariska.
So I actually wish I had you here after all of that.
Let me give you the space, Mariska, everybody.
Thank you so much. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Wow, how do I top that, right? First, the announcement of an amazing new route of District 6 and No Bridge. You know, a lot of hard work went into that, and then Lebohang, I mean, your beautiful words, thank you for your inspirational interpretation of what the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon is really about. Preparation, inspiration, celebration, and then of course that spirit of Africa, Ubuntu. What a wonderful way to mark 80 days until the big event, and what a way to inspire all of us for
what still lies ahead. Yes, 8 years ago when Sanlam decided to partner with the organizers of the Cape Town Marathon, we had a shared dream, one that's been spoken about many times today. A dream to take a relatively small local event and catapult it onto a global stage to become Africa's first major. And now we're one step closer. It's our first year of being an Abbott World Marathon Major candidate. And yeah, I'm so very proud to be part of this very, very special event. This year, Sanlam wants to celebrate everything that can be achieved if we work together to a shared vision with our theme, African Champions Unite. The theme talks to what Sanlam is about, a Pan-African champion, one that is there to drive financial inclusion across our continent, and to empower generations of Africans to be financially confident, secure, and prosperous. This event, like so many others that we've seen recently, shines a light on the immense talent we have. I think Clark spoke to that immense talent that we have from a marathon perspective, right? And it aligns perfectly with Sanlam wanting to drive confidence across this continent and wanting to work together with partners like these to do really, really big things. So we want to encourage everyone, runners of all ages, of all levels, SIP and Alderman J.P. Smith, to come and join us, to come and run the marathon with us on the 15th and the 16th. But it's not just about the runners. It's also about our communities coming together. It's about the supporters coming to support on the route. We are all united as Africans, and we all want to achieve this amazing thing. From a Sanlam perspective, to encourage everyone a little more, we are going to charter a big plane and give 80 runners in Gauteng an opportunity to come and join us here in Cape Town with some return flights. We also want to put up a prize to one lucky participant to give the opportunity to go and run another major marathon, because we will be there soon next year. So that's a nice prize to encourage everyone. I think, again, like Alderman J.P. Smith said, major marathons attract competitors, they attract runners, they attract supporters to their host countries, and they boost economies. And we do believe that this major marathon at the tip of Africa can do just that. It can boost our tourism, it can boost our economy, it can impact lives positively in South Africa, but also beyond our borders. Another thing around living positively, and we will continue championing a cause that's very close to our heart, the cancer cause. And we want to also encourage runners to dedicate their run and their fundraising to cancer. So if you're lacing up to do the marathon, whether you're braving those trail runs, just joining us for the peace runs, I'm definitely also going to do one of the peace runs. I'm not committing to which one just yet. if you're just cheering, if you're supporting a cause, in our eyes, you are already an African champion, because you're helping us to make this African dream a reality. And like Mabel Hunt said, that African proverb has never been truer. If you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. So we're inviting all African champions to unite about this race. Thank you so much.
Thank you, you mentioned the trail ride, which is very, very exciting. I mean, there's such a bouquet of events that are going to be taking place during race week. And of course, the introduction of the Cape Town Trail Run last year was very, very exciting for a lot of our trail snakes out there. So here are some highlights and a glimpse of what our trail runners can look forward to.
Thank you.
Cape Town there. All right, so much natural beauty and just so much to be proud of with regards to our city. And of course, in a continuous effort to be a more sustainable event, the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon has implemented many interventions over the past few years. This year is no different. I'd like to welcome onto the stage Renee Jordan and Lisa Ellis, who will talk to us around one of the greenest races in Africa, as well as Dan Davis from Coca-Cola Peninsula Beverages, who was meant to join us today but is unfortunately ill. But we will proceed. Please welcome.
Thank you.
Renee, I'll start with you. Let's talk a little bit about, you know, recognizing the importance of marathon running, but also how to make it sustainable and make it work with the city where it operates. How do you think that marriage is possible?
I think, you know, from Mariska was actually saying the 8-year partnership, for the last 8 years, the event has built on a sustainable story. So for us, it's not just starting the sustainable story now that we're moving toward Abbott World Marathon Majors. It's something that we've been steadily been working on. And yeah, I think just, you know, since 2014, we have really strived to become a greener event and lessen the impact of the event on the environment. And with the help of Sanlam in 2014, the event was one of the first events to be a climate neutral event, one of the first in Africa. So that's something that we're quite proud of and since continued doing that with the help of Sanlam. And then in 2016, we introduced the Run Green campaign. And that was just part of the Run for Change legacy, to make sure that runners are educated and understand the impact when they're running. So I think coming back to your question, you know, I think often people get so caught up in the emotions of the marathon and the training that maybe sometimes the sustainability is left last, but that's definitely not the case when it comes to the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon. So yeah, and I think just small things that we've done over the last couple of years, we implemented something as simple as putting netting over the water drains and netting in environmental sensitive areas like Lisbeth Parkway and the promenade, so that the plastic sachets don't wash into the drains and eventually land up on landfills or in our oceans. Yeah, that has just grown and grown. And in 2018, the event received an award from AIMS, a global running body that recognized our environmental efforts, and we were awarded the Green Award for our environmental practices. So there's been a lot of, almost when we say small actions, and I think that's the secret of good sustainability. You know, it's not just doing the talk, but through the actions that we've done to build on that plan. And then, yeah, we're very excited. That was just the foundation. We're very excited to also announce today that apart from our revised route, that with our partners in Coca-Cola Peninsula Beverages, we will be removing single-use plastic water sachets from our water points, yeah, and that will be replaced with paper cups. So with our partners, and a lot of consultation, the collaboration has taken place over the last couple of months, and we'll continue to do so to develop the plan. But yeah, we feel that it's really a big step in a positive way for our sustainability. And runners, I know the first thing, especially the marathon runners, they're so used to just grabbing, you know, a plastic sachet and drinking it. Mm-hmm. So there would have to be some adaption and change. And I think, you know, I used to do long runs many moons, like Ilana said, many years ago. But yeah, long runs with on your own, you know, when you're normally doing your training, you're self-sufficient. You know, you run with a hydration pack or you run with a bottle, you refill, you plan the stations where you're going to stop along your route, you know, and fill up. And we want to encourage runners that already do that in practice when they're training to also take the next step and start doing it on the marathon. But for those that's still not comfortable running with hydration packs or bottles yet, you know, we want to say, of course, there will be plenty of product on the route. Ben Bev will be providing ice cold water, Coke, you know, sugar-free Coke, as well as Powerade at 15 refreshment stations that we will have along the route. And for those that do run with hydration packs or with bottles, all of those stations will also be refill stations. So they don't have to worry about, you know, you filling up and that has to last the whole marathon. You can also get some cold water refilled. But yeah, it's just a step in the right direction. And for our trail event, we already in 2018, we said, let's really embrace the Carry Your Own campaign. A bit of a hybrid approach as well with water points along the route, but most of our trail runners are self-sufficient, and we've seen the success of that. So no, we're very excited. And as I said, we'll continue this journey with our sponsors and partners and our environmental partners to constantly work towards you know, the sustainability plan, and also look at best practice. Of course, there we will be looking to other World Abbot majors as well to see what they're doing and constantly evolving the plan. And then, yeah, before I hand over to Lisa, I think just there are some small little surprises that we'll keep for later announcements, but I think we will, again, it will be through our actions that we will speak our sustainability plan.
Thank you for that. So important. Takes a village to look after the village. Yeah, I cannot imagine just now. Lisa, over to you. Love the brand.
Thank you.
And you know what? One of my favorite things is that the sustainability conversation with Adidas is not a new thing. You guys have been about it for so, so long. Tell us about your journey around sustainability so far.
Awesome. So thank you. It's an honor to be here, and it really excites me that we all seem to be speaking the same language when it comes to sustainability. So Adidas has had a 20-year journey so far in sustainability, with our key goal to reach climate neutrality across our entire value chain by 2050. So it's a long journey, it's a marathon, it's not a short race, but we are on the route to get there.
And I know that Adidas is involved in eliminating plastic waste at a global level. Please tell us a little bit about some of the initiatives that you guys are involved in as a brand.
Yes, so our key commitment and core commitment as a global brand is to end plastic waste. We're very serious about this, so the announcement that PenBev will be removing the plastic sachets along the route ties in perfectly with what we stand for. We've just, I don't know if anyone heard of the Run for the Oceans campaign and event that we've just wrapped up our third year, and together with our partners, Parley for the Oceans, we committed to removing the equivalent weight of one plastic bottle for every 10 minutes that our participants ran. And as a result, we'll be removing 250,000 kilograms of plastic from our international coastlines and communities. And this will then most likely be produced into yarn and reused into a lot of our products.
And then how does this mindset apply to your retail operation?
Yes, so all of our stores have a retail or sustainability element and focus, especially the new ones and our refurbished stores. Our retail directors opening stores left, right, and center, no one can keep up, but there is a key sustainability focus. We've just launched last year, it feels like just the other day, our most sustainable Adidas store within Africa, just down the road at the V&A waterfront. So for those that haven't been, I encourage you to go and see. Our team are looking at really innovative ways to bring this to life in the most sustainable way. So you'll see live plant walls, we've got reclaimed cashier desks, and many other recycled materials down to the product as well. And we'll make sure going into Expo, a big focus for us for the next few months, that we'll bring a lot of this approach and elements to there, so keep a lookout.
Speaking of approach, what is the brand's approach when it comes to the actual Adidas product?
Yes, so this has also been a long journey. Currently, 60% of our products are made from recycled materials, and by 2025, which is just around the corner, and hopefully the year that Sanlam Cape Town Marathon will become a World Abbot Major, Adidas will have 9 out of 10 articles, which is product, that will be made from recyclable materials. Yeah. So the marathon eventee that all marathon participants will receive with their entries at registration, I'm wearing it here today, is also made from 100% recyclable materials, and you'll see it's very breathable. So really, you can still achieve that technical aspect by using the recycled material. As well as the jacket. And then the jacket as well. So this is the official Adidas Cape Town Marathon jacket. Also 100% recycled materials, and it will be available for purchase at the expo. But if you can't wait, you can pre-order on the Cape Town Marathon website as well.
Thank you so much. Just the partnership makes sense. I mean, come on. It all makes sense. Thank you so much, ladies. Appreciate it. I love the conversation around sustainability and also what we can do as not only runners, not only spectators, as Cape Town residents, to make this, you know, one of the most sustainable races on the continent. It's a team effort, everyone. Thank you all for joining us this morning. Some of the stakeholders, sponsors, partners will be milling around. So if you do want to ask a question one-on-one with them, please feel free to grab a Clark or a Barry or anyone that you see around that you have any questions for. I'm sure they'll be very happy to answer them. Otherwise, that puts a wrap on the proceedings. There'll be a couple more events to look forward to in the lead up to the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon in October. So I look forward to seeing you all there. But otherwise, those of you who are running, good luck. Those of you who will be covering those who are running, good luck to you too. Otherwise, we do the countdown, 80 days until the Sanlam Cape Town Marathon. All very, very exciting. So many exciting things happening in the city. I know for me, being on the radio every morning, broadcasting to the Western Cape, there is not a dull day being a part of this city. So also our pleasure as media partners at KFM 94.5 to be a part of this phenomenal, phenomenal event. So thank you all for joining us. You can go back to your desks, your cubicles, your write-ups, etc.